Ness City, here we come.
Yeah, here we go, Ness City, back our fourth time.
My third.
And Neil's third. Guys, we have a lot of good memories from our prior investigations.
A lot of weird stuff went on.
You guys remember the whistles?
Do you want us to leave? Hello?
Phenomenal.
They were making us look like an episode of Scooby-Doo going back and forth across that top floor.
We still never figured out where they came from.
No, we don't. So we're hoping that it gets replicated tonight.
We did the dueling rim pods.
Yeah.
The dueling rim pods.
Yeah,
we figured out. About, what, 30 to 40 feet apart?
Yeah, two separate rooms.
Two separate rooms had rim pod in each, and they're going off almost identical.
Oh, that's yours, Kevin.
Whoa, that's been going off now.
Yes.
Is there anybody here with us?
We need you to light those lights up again, please. Better yet, whistle.
I don't think you
can
whistle.
Yep. And we can't forget about Ethel.
Yeah.
Ethel.
What was that about? Please don't leave us.
Please don't leave us.
Please don't leave us.
Yeah, we need you, or something like that. Yeah. That's still, I think, one of our better EVPs.
And then there's the ever-popular cheeseburger.
What did that one...
That's right.
One board member think it was?
He's hoping maybe it could be like a Renberger, or...
Yeah, last name of somebody around that area.
With a name from the place that was tied to the building.
Correlate to the building.
City, right. Mm-hmm.
Still my favorite, which I hope we can maybe catch something tonight, is upstairs in the old Masonic area, the gavel, you know, and there was also a courthouse at one time too.
Yeah, we heard a lot of knocks on
those,
the
floor. Those knocks, what it sounded like a gavel to me.
Yeah.
Another one of the things that we caught the very first time we were there was where the rim device. I think that may have been the first time you used your REM device.
Oh, upstairs. We were asking, you know, during the EVP session, if it was a judge or, you know, if it was a lawyer or, you know, maybe you were the convict.
Were you a judge here in this courtroom? Or maybe you were a criminal that was convicted in prison?
Dude.
Well, we have some really cool new equipment we're bringing along tonight. So we have a motion detector, a 360-degree
motion detector that's brand new. Got a super high-powered new laser grid we're going to try out. And skeletal mapping.
Skeletal mapping. Can't wait. You know, it's amazing, guys, how much our equipment arsenal has changed over the last year and a half since we've been
there. Our equipment has grown. No, I hope it's active like it has been in the past. I am excited to be back here in Ness County, Ness City Bank Building, and hey, I think we're going to have a good night tonight.
Preparing and setting up for an investigation at a location Old School Paranormal has not only put on the paranormal map in western Kansas, like the Ness County Bank Building, but also have been to numerous times. It's a lot different than preparing and setting up for a location for our very first time.
What the hell?
Yeah, dude, that whistle.
Yeah.
Where did that sound like it came from?
I don't know, but it was very distinct. See, I can tell. Because I just started walking into that room there.
Did you start before or after the whistle?
Before. How are we looking there, Captain?
I think we're good.
Good?
Yep. Looks good. Good to go.
The Ness County Bank Building in the previous three investigations have all produced different types of unexplainable activity, to where it's almost impossible to cover each and every spot in the building that's produced results in the past.
You maybe remember us from when we were here, well, it's been over a year ago, with the nice lady who said, please don't leave us, we need you. Can you tell us why? Is there something that we can do for you? You're a lot of the reason that we've come back. We're hoping to communicate more with you. Yeah, you can communicate through that if you would like. Is your name Ethel?
Wow. Good. Nice. Thank you.
It's time to move around a little quicker. Oh, sorry.
If you are a Southern woman, could you please light that device again?
So if the woman who did speak to us before, who said, please don't leave me, if you are here with us, we also think you might have said, we need you. What did you mean by that?
But if I may be honest, it's Scott.
There was a thud or a thump.
Did you hear that, Neil? Mm-hmm. Okay. It almost sounded right above me.
Yeah.
Steve, did you lock that front door? Let me go check. You ready to go with?
I got it.
Do you by chance know who might have made that sound above us?
So can you tell us your name?
What was that?
That almost sounded like a deep sigh.
Yeah.
Like a...
I didn't hear that. Were you trying to tell us your name?
Steve, coming downstairs.
What's that?
Steve, by chance, when you were up there, did you have a big sigh?
Yeah, we can.
Like a...
Yeah. How long after I went up?
Probably about halfway through. Neil and I heard a
okay,
big...
Okay, guys. I don't know.
Kevin asked to tell us what your name was, and then Scott and I heard a big sigh. Like...
No, I was pretty quiet up there.
Now, I did hang up that alarm. Did you guys hear
it? Yeah, we heard that. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But that, I mean, you would have remembered it because it had to be, it would had to be a loud sigh.
Well, if I was in that big room, there's no way that. Okay. Yeah, I was very cognizant because I knew Neil's camera was going on, so I didn't want to pick my nose or or anything like that.
Because we've caught whistling every time we've investigated the building, it was time to ask the whistler to present themselves.
Who in here likes to whistle? We love whistling. Can you whistle us a tune?
What about the girl that was hiding or crying? There was a little girl that... leave Scott when Scott was wanting to play hide and seek. We picked up a little girl's voice that said either I'm hiding or maybe even crying.
Or maybe your name's Heidi.
At that very moment, up on the third floor. It's amazing that we caught what sounds like a child or a female sobbing when asking the question of where the little girl was that was crying or hiding at our July 2015 investigation.
If you want us to move on, you need to tell us, okay? Light up one of these devices. Move the chair. Can you light up the periscope again? One with all the different color lights?
Did you work in this building at some point?
You guys want to move?
Are we okay?
Yeah, we want to go to the gift shop.
The gift shop as well. Yeah.
The gift shop in the building's basement is one of the areas that the team usually does not investigate, but since it's the last investigation of this location, the team found it necessary to check it out one last time.
So you heard that sigh when I went upstairs?
Yeah, you went upstairs to go make sure the front door was locked, and I was standing at the bottom of the staircase, or actually a couple stairs up, steps up from the bottom, and Neil was at the bottom. We heard a near the... You're probably gone a good minute or so, minute and a half, and we just heard a that we both heard, and we thought maybe it's you. But if it was you, you would have remembered it because it was. I mean, you would have to done it loud for us to be able to hear it.
I had just got done asking if you can tell us your name, and I wasn't paying attention to that, and I didn't hear it.
And prior to that, and the whole reason you went upstairs to check to make sure the front door is locked.
Because we heard that thumb.
Exactly, yeah. We heard it.
Mm-hmm.
And there was somebody up there.
Yeah, and there was nothing upstairs that was knocked over, tipped over, unsettled or anything like that. Nothing looked out of place at all.
Is there anybody in here with us? In the gift shop? What is now a gift shop? Can you make it go back to green? Whoever's in here, please make that go back to green. Can you show me the color green?
Flash. So who's in here with us tonight?
That's Scott's side.
That's in my.
So it's been stuck on that orange red for.
Did you reset it? Oh, it's moved.
Yep, it did. Did that bother you when I stepped towards it? That's pretty ironic. It didn't move until I stepped towards it.
What used to be in this part of the building long before it was a gift shop?
Meanwhile, back on the third floor, our equipment continued to pick up activity. the ultra-sensitive 360-degree motion detector picked up something moving in the completely empty room.
We are here at the Ness County Bank Building, down in a gift shop. Steve and the other guys have been down here before. This is my first time in the gift shop, third time at the bank building. We had the periscope go off a little bit earlier, and we're not sure if it was us or something else causing it to go off. But we're going to be moving up stairs here pretty quick. We just wanted to give the gift shop a see if we could find anything down here.
Team continued to have lots of activity up on the third floor. Directly below us on the second floor, a static camera was able to record a REM device going off in the same room where our skeletal mapping equipment was set up. Although the mapping equipment did not detect anything on screen, the fact that someone or something triggered the REM device is very interesting, since nobody was on the second floor at the time to set off the proximity device. You can faintly hear the team's voices coming directly from the floor above.
Go touch that train on the other end of the room.
Move a little bit.
Oh, that's quick little couple movements.
Are you going towards the train? You're trying to?
Right there, you see that train? If you can do that, I won't be impressed. Because that takes a lot of energy. Can you show us?
You hear something, John?
I don't know what that was, Tag, a few seconds ago. It sounded like a voice to me.
That was Steve. I'm gonna go around, check it out.
If you want help with something, tell us.
Set off that train again. Bet you can't do it, can you?
Where did you go?
Is that all you have?
We're not done talking with you yet.
I bet you can't do that train again.
Come over to this other blue light. You can get some energy.
Guy, am I sending that off?
Yes.
Jimmy. Flippin' Christmas. Okay.
Okay, I'm stopping.
Why can't you not touch the rim for the train anymore? You just like the pretty colors? I still think you're a convict, aren't you? You didn't like that.
Have you been in jail before? If you have, okay.
Train.
What were you in jail for?
Was for stealing a train?
I was gonna say robbing a train.
Robbing a train, yeah.
Steve and Kevin left the room to investigate noises heard down the hall. Scott and Neil stayed behind to try to find out exactly who we were communicating with. As we were learning, the third floor was by far the most active location in the building that night.
Okay, now those two guys are gone. We can get the party started in here.
Hey, thank you.
Is that what you're waiting on for those two to leave?
Keep going.
You want them to come back? How long did you spend in jail, prison? Was it less than 10 years?
It was after this question from Scott that our audio recorders picked up this very distinct EVP intelligent response.
Was it less than 10 years? More than 10 years? Thank you for trying to communicate with us. Sounds like the guys are on their way back. Does that make you happy? Is it okay if those two come back in here? Both pairs are going off.
Both pairs are
going off. Yes. Okay, here we are all again. All are again. Were you glad when those two left?
I'm going to go after the scan.
Okay.
See if I can get something to touch me. Let me know if you can see me.
See you.
You see me?
Yep. You're at the very top of the screen.
Alright, here I am.
Go out there and meet Kevin.
I'm right here next to the body you're lighting up. Can you touch my hand?
Welcome him here. Yep. How are you going?
You can't hurt me, but you can stand next to me.
You set every device off. Up here that we've got. Can you do one of them again, please? Go out there. Come on, yeah. Right here. Or you want me to leave so you can play with the devices? I'm gonna step back. It's all yours.
That's me. Can you whistle like that?
Whoa.
What is it with this building and whistling? Step away from it now! Thank you. There's something going on in this room.
Possibly.
Instead of intelligent.
I'm not considering anything intelligent.
I mean, they don't have any clear responses.
No.
Other than mentioning the convict, and we got some responses.
This is true.
Are you still that convict? If you are, touch it again. It mustn't be very fun being stuck in this building.
All rise. The honorable judge is here. Court is in session. How do you plead, convict? Do you plead guilty? Do you plead innocent?
You plead the fifth? You plead insanity?
Or do you plead no contest? We're not going to waste your time much longer with you, convict. And you know that there's not much opportunity for you to try to communicate with this world. So when we leave, it's going to be a long time before you'll have this opportunity again. So either you step up and start communicating with us again, or we leave.
Fine. You just want us to move on?
times we've had this room go crazy with REM pod and K2 hits, and then we've also had the whistling. So, and it usually starts around 11 o'clock. That's when it's happened in the past. So let's hope we start hearing some whistles and some activity in this room.
Is there someone here with us on the second floor tonight?
Is the whistler with us tonight?
Do you know who is up on third floor?
Is it okay that we're here tonight?
Use the white noise of that device.
Say anything. Tell us to get out. You don't want us here. Well, if you need help, tell us too.
Steve and I heard the whistle when we first got up here this afternoon.
Yeah. Where'd you go?
Didn't that happen last night?
Yes, it did. It was up in the same area.
Yeah, somebody heard people whistling that day.
Well, it is 11:09.
Hey, did you just hear that?
Yes.
Was that breathing?
Did you just yawn or anything? Hmm.
Scott, did you yawn or anything?
Yeah.
I heard the whistle.
So did I. Do that again. Can you whistle again for us, please?
Even though we heard live a light whistle, the second floor, which in the past has been the most active location in the building, bar none, was very quiet that night.
All right, so it's 12:12, and the teams have split up into individual floors. I'm on the first floor here in the conference room of the Ness County Bank Building, and it's been a relatively quiet night. We had some pretty interesting activity up on the top floor. Oh, an hour and a half or so, maybe 2 hours ago. A lot of devices were going off. We use that room to test the skeletal mapping system that we have. Works great picking us up, but so far we haven't picked anything else up, at least while we're up there.
Last time we were here, been over a year ago, we got an EVP that we feel like it said, please don't leave us, we need you. We were hoping to make contact with that same person again this evening, so I'm gonna give it a shot. If there is someone with me making that light up, can you please step away, make it shut off, and then light it up again? Thank you. How can I help you? You can communicate through, show yourself on the camera. There's some red lights in a rocking chair.
make them light up. You can talk into the audio recorders, and we'll hear your voice. Or you can light that device that was on earlier with the green and red and yellow lights. Is there a child down here with me? I need you to somehow let me know that there is someone here with me tonight. You need to communicate with me some way. Is someone here with me? Lighting up that device. If there is, can you make the light change colors? Move it on around the device. Come over here by me.
Hoping to get a little activity, a little response from somebody. If it's just you and I here, you know, in the past we've had some interactions in here with what we thought was a younger girl who maybe lived in these apartments at one time. Are you by chance here with us now? You're with me now?
All right. Is anything going on up here?
This is the third floor where we're at. Hopefully tonight we can get some knocking like we did last time. Used to be a courthouse at one time. There's also a Masonic room up here. So, hoping we can catch some good stuff.
Perhaps there is a lady, or Ethel, maybe? There's an Ethel here. You know, like we've said all night long, there's no reason to be afraid or scared of us. We will not harm you, nor will any of our equipment. And we're not here to take you away from your home. Any entities that may be residing here still?
Kevin, come down. Anybody down here?
Yeah, I'm down here.
Sorry.
What's going on up there?
I think you creeped out, but there's a lot of sounds. Like a lot of weird banging and... Not banging, but... Definitely some sounds.
Yeah. You want to switch?
I'm freaking out tonight. I don't know why.
It's alright.
We need somebody to communicate.
So last time we were up here, I believe we were talking to a convict, a prisoner. All right. First of all, I still have that silver dollar. It can be yours. It's right here. Okay? It's right here. I'm putting it on the brim. That's yours. All you have to do is take it. I'm giving it to you. But you can't just have it. You've got to take it. So, who's here? Who wants to play? Huh? If you wanted to, go ahead and knock one of those tables down. That'll let me know that you're here. Thank you. Thank you for showing me. The train, that's right. I appreciate that. Can you touch one of the other devices? What's significant about the train that you chose to touch it? Maybe you helped build the railroads around this area. I want to know what it is. When you were in this building, when you were alive in this building.
I was just upstairs, third level. And there were some weird sounds going on that kind of freaked me out a little bit, so Travis Scott here.
So were you a judge? Okay. Did you help build? Did you help build this building? And see, Merrill, maybe it's you that's here.
Just very eerily quiet here at the Ness County Bank Building. Fourth time here, but probably quieter than it's ever been for us. You know, and that's the thing about paranormal investigating. You don't know what you're going to get. And it's really never, ever the same the next time you go back.
Kevin got a little spooked, and it's, you know, been the most active place tonight so far, Florida way. So went up there, and shortly after I was up there, yeah, the train started going off a little bit, and got a little activity on the rim pod as well. So, you know, I left them up there, hoping that they interact with Neil next.
Earlier we were up here, we had several devices going off. We had a REM pod, two periscopes, possibly Kevin's motion detector. Seemed to get a lot of activity when we were mentioning convicts. I don't know if we were dealing with a convict here or just coincidence. So I'm gonna try and that line of questioning again and see if I can get a response from a convict.
Okay, it's just you and me, convict. One-on-one, just you and me. There's not four of us up here now, it's just one. I need you to communicate with me, one way or another. Go out here and stand amongst the devices. Come out here by me. Stand next to me. I don't think you can do it. Feel free to go to that blue light. You can get energy from that light to light up these devices or manifest. Are you a past Mason, Masonic member, of there any Masonic members here with me tonight? Is there someone here who doesn't like the Masons? You don't have to be afraid of me. I'm just a little guy. I'm definitely not afraid of you. Or maybe you're a judge trying to get control of this court. Walk over here to the Masonic side. Does all the traffic outside bother you? Just heard some clicking noise off down the hallway.
Here I am on the third floor. This is Steve coming in. And I want a friendly conversation. No ill will meant. Please light up one of the devices. You up here? Who's up here? Is the criminal still up here? The convict? Why are you still up here? Fact. That would be the train. Thank you. Now, just to make sure, I'm going to do the exact same thing, get up out of my chair, see if it goes off again. Nope. I want you to knock two times on the wall, on the floor, loud enough so I can hear you. Heard a tap from the other room. Can't say whether or not that was a response or not. Heard footsteps coming from that direction. Who's over in that room? Not even a minute ago, I heard distinct footsteps coming from that direction over my left shoulder. I'm on the top floor. There's nobody above me. Can you do that again? Hey, Neil, are you on the second floor?
Yes, sir.
Were you walking around like a minute and a half ago?
I was walking up the stairs.
Up to the top floor?
Up to the second floor. Kevin's actually walking around right now. I don't know if you can hear him or not.
Yep, debunked. Yep, I can hear him.
Okay, that's probably what it was then.
Okay, so that's been debunked. You know, it's part of paranormal investigations. We're not here to prove that everything is a ghost. So we do our best to debunk what could be construed as paranormal activity.
Case in point, this strange noise was caught on an audio recorder on the third floor of the bank building. It appears to be a demonic type of scream or screech. However, upon review of our main floor static camera, it was nothing more than a car turning the corner just outside the building and spinning its tires on the rain-soaked brick streets. The howling demon has been debunked.
So when we're in this room and all these devices are going off,
multiple feet away from each other, and three or four of them are going off at the same time. You gotta think, what's causing that to happen? And we didn't have a rational explanation for that. And so that's what paranormal is. Doesn't mean it's haunted.
We have this new friend here. New buddy, Steve is showing you. You can play with it all you want. See it? Lights up. So, you can touch it and it's, the arms will light up. Boo Buddy here, you can definitely touch Boo Buddy. And you can be standing right next to me at the same time. We can tell if you're standing next to me. So, maybe you can grab my hand and hold my hand for a while. I'm not here to hurt you. I'm here to be your friend. See, Boo Buddy wants to be your friend too.
So we're about ready to wrap it up. The guys are on the second floor starting to gather up equipment, tearing down the cameras and so forth. So looks like we're going to be going lights on here pretty quick and start to call it a night and get ready for the hour trip home. This was, for all intents and purposes, our last investigation at the iconic Ness County Bank Building. 2 years ago, when Old School Paranormal was the very first team to ever investigate this grand old building, we seemed to have woken up whoever or whatever was in the building, desperately wanting to tell us their story. But now it's time to move on. In some ways, it appears that we've worn our welcome for the residents that have, for whatever reason, decided to remain in the building. But for our team, it will always leave us with countless unanswered questions. In our opinion, those questions will never be answered, no matter who walks through those doors to figure out why the building holds so many mysteries a secret.